Back with us to discuss this topic is our good friend and top infectious disease specialist, Dr. Brad Spellberg. I'd like to bring in our good friend. She's triple board certified clinical neuropsychologist, Dr. Judy Ho. She's host of the podcast, Supercharged Life with Dr. Judy. Hey, Dr. Judy.
Hey, Dr. Ian, how are you today?
Good, good. So listen, Dr. Judy, you know, there's a lot of concern about people as regards of getting the vaccine. They're afraid of getting the vaccine. What do people you talk to, what are they saying that's bothering them? And how can that be addressed?
Well, Dr. E, I'm so glad you're doing this segment with Dr. Spellberg, because this is the problem. There is so much fear and mistrust in general right now. Recently, the nonpartisan group Kaiser Family Foundation just surveyed 1,200 people, and they found that only 42% of people would get the vaccine right now, and about 80% of people thought that the vaccine and the information about it is politically motivated rather than being rooted in the science. And what's even more concerning is that there's been a 16% drop in the public confidence from information coming out from the CDC. So there's a huge blind spot right now, I think, when people are thinking about how can we move forward, because people are feeling hopeless, yet they're reluctant to trust the medical data. So we really have to really educate people once again, really separate the facts from the opinions. And I think that that's part of the problem, Dr. Ian, is that when you look at the news now, sometimes it's really just opinions rather than the facts. It's people thinking about what their opinions are and what they've talked about with their family members and friends. And we really have to get away from that and get back to the science.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. You know, I said on my Instagram page way back in March that the scientists need to start leading the conversation, because we're going to find ourselves in a position where politics and opinion have led the conversation. And now science has the really difficult task of trying to come back in front and get back out there and correct all of the misperceptions and misconceptions. And so, you know, you look at President Obama said that, listen, he understands the need for us to take the vaccine, and he understands about the mistrust people have. He's going to go on camera and actually take it, so people realize that it's okay to take it. I think that's a big step in helping people. But Dr. Judy, what else can help people kind of, you know, allay some of that mistrust?
Absolutely. Seeing world leaders model good behavior, it really does make a difference in our minds, because when we are feeling distressed, like many people are right now, we really do look to the people in our lives that are aspirational for us. And we're thinking, what are they doing? And even though the statistics should be driving those decisions, it does make a difference when somebody we respect and somebody we look up to is saying it's okay. So I'm glad that he, and I hope other leaders will come forward and do similar things. But also it's helpful at this moment in time to stay flexible. There's a really important therapeutic technique that I talk about with my patients called psychological flexibility. And this technique is all about staying in contact with the present moment and doing what is needed and not being too rigid and trying to hold to certain ideas that maybe you thought a week ago was going to work. We know that this is a rapidly evolving situation. So we have to sort of take the information from moment to moment and try to make logical decisions. And more than ever, this is the time to talk to your doctors. I know a lot of my patients are saying, I haven't spoken to my medical doctors because I don't know what to believe. Well, if you don't believe one medical doctor, talk to a second one, get a second opinion, but really do go back and rely on your physicians. Ask them what they think. Ask them what the new studies are showing. Really have those types of engaging conversations with your medical doctors and not so much always with your friends and family members.
Absolutely. No doubt.